never gone fishing. Never gone fishing? I went one time fishing. It wasn't my favorite. As you might know from my personality, maybe waiting is not my best thing, not my best attribute of waiting. So there's all different kinds of fishing. Who's ever done deep sea fishing? Okay, not you. Deep sea fishing is when you go out on a boat way out into the ocean and you're trying to get huge, big fish and you catch that in one particular way. Yes? You haven't gone fishing yet either, Rachel? Well, maybe this summer you'll go fishing. Maybe. Maybe. Yeah, I hope there's no fish in the pool. Yeah, when you go swimming. Yeah, no fish there. Or you might go fishing just standing at the shore and you throw in your pole. And what kind of things do you put on the end of a pole to catch fish? What might you put?
I'd put a worm.
A worm. A worm would be a good thing. Let's put a worm. Okay. So a worm might be a good thing to catch a fish. Okay, so we got some worms. What else might we have? Something shiny and sparkly that attracts them. Yes, I've heard that too. A worm? A pink worm? Oh, to catch fish? Oh, the rubber. But that's all right. You sometimes use what's called lure, and because it gets them to be attracted, like something shiny or with feathers on it. Or you might have like a little bobber on top that you'll know when a fish comes. So there's all kinds of ways to bait and get a fish. In our story today, these fishermen, they threw big nets out in order to catch the, maybe you'd like to catch some fish. Would you like to catch some fish? Go ahead. You want to take a couple fish? They threw big, three is perfect. They would throw out big nets and you can have them. Yeah. They would throw out big nets and catch their fish. Now that was their whole life. They ate the fish they caught. They sold the fish that they caught. They spent all their day long doing fishing. That's what they did. Now along comes Jesus and he says to them, I want you to come with me and share the good news. We're going to talk about what the good news is. And did they say no or did they say yes? They followed him. They said yes. Not only did they say yes, they didn't go, like Pastor Sally did this morning. They said yes. They threw down their nets and they went just like that. And you're going to talk more about that in Connect today, about dropping everything and going. Okay, so, but when they left, they didn't right away start to go out and fish for people or try to get more people to know about God's love. First, Jesus taught them and shared with him about how he felt about God and about God's love and about how you would share God's love. So he was teaching them how to use the right bait. He was teaching them how to not only share the good news, but be the good news. Because it's a little hard to, what if you've never made a cake before, but you have the directions, and you tell someone, you put in flour, you put in sugar, you put in some baking soda, you put in some eggs, but you've never actually made a cake before. Do you think you'd be a better teacher if you actually had made a cake before? Do you think you? Yeah, you would be, wouldn't you? So that's what Jesus was saying. You have to be the good news. You have to love God with your whole heart to be able to share that with somebody else. Because you are the bait. You are the good news. So it's our job to learn about God's love, to put that love in our heart, to know how to then share it with somebody else. Because today's story tells us that it's our job to reel those people in, to tell them about God's love, and to let them know how wonderful it is to have that love in our hearts. Let us pray. Dear God, you've given us all the bait we need. You show us the love, the kindness, the compassion, the caring, the listening, Let us take that good news and put it in our hearts and go out and share that good news. Amen.